What's going on, guys? I'm here reacting to Black Sails. Okay, so last episode, the main thing that I really am focusing on is Vane. He has made his way to where Flint is, and he's about to fuck up the whole thing. I did not even recognize Eleanor's dad last episode. Oh my goodness, I can't believe he died. So now Eleanor has lost her probably biggest ally, right? Aside from Flint. I have no idea what she's gonna do. I'm excited to see how Lord Ash interacts with Flint and Miranda. Like, this is gonna be interesting, so let's dive right in.
I can't say enough of this, how saddened we all are by this loss. All my life I was a pauper. With your father's help, I plied a trade. I'll always be grateful for that.
I can imagine how difficult this must be. Being the daughter they expect you to be.
There is no part of this that is complicated. I crossed Charles, he retaliated. That is what happens in a war.
A war?
Everyone must take a side, he says. With him, against reconciliation with England, or with me. Those people out there heard him. And they came to my door not to pay their respects. But because when this war begins, they want to make sure I don't mistake them for enemies. Is that why you've come? Or have you yet to choose a side?
I have seen what she can destroy when she is angered.
Which of the two was she just now?
She was something else entirely. How soon can you be ready to sail?
Just finalizing the route, sorting out supplies. I assume we depart tomorrow at some point.
Leave as soon as possible. There are foul things brewing here.
She's contemplating killing Max, yeah?
Would seem only reasonable then that I bear an equal measure of gratitude to the man who rescued her from it. Were it not for that gratitude, you and I would not be speaking like this. You and Colonel Rhett would be having a very different conversation. Because while I knew you once, called you friends once, I cannot fathom how those people I knew turned into you.
It took us 4 months to secure our first significant prize.
How did you manage that so quickly?
I met a man in a tavern, quartermaster of a well-respected crew. I persuaded him that I was someone worth listening to. A crew followed shortly thereafter.
And how long after that was it that you decided to murder Alfred Hamilton?
I received a letter. If you're going to blame anyone for it, please blame me.
Let us agree that if either one of you gets any closer to the governor than you just did, I will be forced to consider that a threat to his person, and I will shoot you where you stand.
When we received that letter from you informing us of Thomas's death,
the damage wrought by Alfred Hamilton was too much for us to bear.
Damn, we still have some kind of weird hope.
He allowed that anger to drive us to a dark deed. But I ask you not to judge me by that one deed. Judge me by the ends that I have come here in service of.
What is it?
I thought I saw something in the water.
You did. You fucking did.
Tell the watch on the main, so they can keep an eye on it.
I'm sure it was nothing.
Tell them anyway.
Smart man.
Before you return home, I had hoped that you and I might share a word. Privately.
What do you wish to speak about?
Ambition, sir. Yours and mine.
I made an appeal to my crew of 100 men, and better than 70 of them are sitting right now just outside your harbor in full support of it. It is exactly as Thomas proposed all those years ago.
Yes, but then we were talking about less than half the number of criminals on the island.
We also didn't have the most respected captain on the island standing in advocacy of our plan. We didn't have a man who has established himself as the new world's most committed pirate hunter endorsing it.
Were I to make this case to the men I know in Whitehall,
The first question that they will ask is, who will oversee all this? Who will be responsible for its success or failure?
I don't think that there's a part for Captain Flint in Nassau's future, not with the blood on his hands. He will have to go away and leave James McGraw and Lady Hamilton to retire to the interior in peace.
Something wrong?
Nerves. I'm fine.
She has a bad feeling.
If he was suspicious, he'd have come down by now.
I'm going to find Randall. See who I can ridicule for the crew's amusement.
Are they on the ship already?
Randall.
Oh,
crew
no.
Dress is due at next bells. Do you have anything new for me by the way of gossip now?
Oh no, they're on the fucking ship, bro. If Vane gets a hold of this ship, he can set off the 100 cannons on the fucking city. Oh my god, that would just be, oh god.
If he says no, it means there's a part of him that is no more. Part of him he doesn't want to let go of.
You said Captain Flint would have to disappear for this plan to work. Are you truly ready to let him go?
I told you of my grandfather who raised me. In his youth, he was a deckhand on a privateer off the coast of Massachusetts. He sees this man climbing out of the water. A stranger approaches my grandfather and asks him for a little rum. Man said that he'd fled his fishing trawler, accused of killing another man. And when asked his name, man simply replied, Mr. Flint. It was as if the sea had conjured that man out of nothing and then taken him back for some unknowable purpose. Truth is, every day I've worn that name, I've hated him a little more. I've been ready to return him to the sea for a long time.
What the fuck do we do now? The moment the ship is clear of the area, if not sooner, Captain Vane will put the crew to the sword, yes?
Most likely.
Eventually they find us down here and do the same. So either we swim to the beach and likely face the news, or else do nothing, in which case it's the sword.
Come with me.
Where are we going?
To execute the third option. Persuade Captain Vane to surrender the ship.
How?
How could I be expected to trust one of you?
How could you trust a pirate?
Exactly.
I am no pirate, sir. I am an Englishwoman. I am my father's daughter. And I will be the end of piracy in this place, and it begins tonight.
What do you mean?
I discovered a plan by one of the crews on the beach to reclaim a prize that is so large it would upset our world here. And I have ended their endeavor before it began.
Well, Anne's there, so that means Jack isn't gonna get fucking killed.
I shouldn't have left the way I did. Without telling you. It wasn't your fault what happened. It was a hard fucking choice put on you.
I didn't think I was gonna see you again.